Welcome in, boys and girls, to another edition of Berg is the Word. My name is Mark Bergin, and Florida just escaped Kentucky with a 29-21 road win. The number 9 team gets it done. And down 11 points on the road, it looked like Kentucky was going to win its first game. Someone already saying Gators suck. It looked like Kentucky was going to win for back-to-back seasons for the first time since 1976 and 1977. But the Gators come storming back after Feleipe Franks' injury. Kyle Trask in relief of Franks. The Gators scored on 3 of his 4 drives. I'm going to break down the end of the game and what I thought, what happened. I'll say this. When Florida got the ball back and they had a 1-point lead, Josh Hammond, who scored a 76-yard touchdown, should not have gone down to score. To give Kentucky a chance to tie it. So Hammond scored a 76-yard touchdown that put the Gators up 7, and then an extra point put the Gators up by 8. Kentucky had 33 seconds left and a timeout, which is an eternity in college football. And that's really coaching and situational awareness. And it nearly cost the Gators. And I'll say this moving forward for the Gators, who, again, are the number 9 ranked team coming into tonight's game. If they make mistakes like that against better teams, it will come back to bite them. Kentucky not able to get it done. Kentucky playing in tonight's game with a backup quarterback. And that's because with Sawyer Smith at quarterback. And that's because Terry Wilson is hurt and out for the rest of the season. Now, as for Feleipe Franks, the Gators quarterback, he got carted off the field with a leg injury. It did not look good. And the Gators, they really rallied. You could see how much it hurt them. But Trask, who's gotten a little bit of playing time, he's a junior, looked really, really good. Again, the Gators scored in 3 of his 4 drives that he was out there. And again, put in a tough situation tonight. Down 11 on the road against Kentucky. And Kentucky, remember, broke the losing streak last year. The Gators had beaten the Wildcats 31 consecutive games. So the Wildcats tonight were hoping to start a streak of their own. And that did not happen. Had the Wildcats won, it would have marked for the first time since 1976 and 1977 that they would have beaten Florida in back-to-back seasons, but it did not happen. And again, the Gators coming back down 11, scoring 19 consecutive points and coming back in tonight's game led by Kyle Trask in relief of Feleipe Franks. That was really the key storyline. And I'll say this too. I think Frank struggled for a big part of tonight's game, but Trask came in and was able to get the job done. And I don't know if the injury really rallied the Gators, but it was a pretty remarkable comeback. And we'll see what happens moving forward. I think Trask is going to be the guy because, you know, Florida's got Tennessee next weekend, and I would be shocked if Franks would be able to go in next weekend's game just because it did not look good. Again, he got carted off the field with some sort of leg injury. He got caught up in a pile trying to reach for a first down, and it did not look good. But Kyle Trask, it looks like, will be the guy for Florida moving forward, at least for the time being. And I'll say this, if he continues to play well and say Franks' injury isn't as bad as some might anticipate, maybe he still might be the guy even if Franks comes back healthy, just with the way that he played and especially the situation that he played as well. Again, on the road in a hostile environment and in a game that's, you know, nationally televised on ESPN and everything too. What a moment for Trask and what a moment for the Gators as they continue to stay undefeated. And again, they avenge last season's loss. Remember, last season's loss, that was a huge, huge win for Kentucky last year because, again, it snapped a 31-game winning streak that the Gators had over the Wildcats. So it goes to show you how lopsided this matchup of these two SEC East teams has been for decades. And, again, a hard-fought game, and it came down to the wire. Again, I'll say this, and I think if I was in the news conference after with Gators coach Dan Mullen, I would ask this: why did Hammond score on the touchdown on the Gators' last offensive drive? It was a 76-yard touchdown, and it did put the game further out of reach for Kentucky. But if he gets the first down and goes down, the Gators can just snap the ball and knee it, and they would have won 22-21. The Wildcats would not have had the timeouts to be able to stop the clock. Hammond goes down and scores the 76-yard touchdown. The Gators wisely take the one, the PAT, because at least with the PAT, if Kentucky does go down and score on their next offensive possession with 33 seconds left, they would at least have to convert a two-point conversion. But what I would ask Dan Mullen is why didn't you tell Josh Hammond to go down on that run, get the first down, and then you can just knee the ball and you can kill the clock that way. And you escape Lexington with a one-point game, and you don't allow Kentucky to get the ball back on offense. That's coaching, and that's situational awareness. And for as good as the SEC is, it's the best conference in all of college football. You've got to be better than that. And if Florida makes a similar mistake against better opponents than Kentucky, I'm talking the Georgias of the world, Alabama, if they were to play other SEC West opponents, if Florida makes the same mistakes against better competition, they will pay the price for making what was a huge mental mistake. Again, 33 seconds in a timeout to drive the length of the field might sound insurmountable to some, but again, remember, in college football, the clock stops until the chain gang can move on first down. The clock stops on first down, so until the chains can move, the clock doesn't start again until the chains are set. So Kentucky wasn't able to take advantage of this. Again, they had a backup quarterback starting tonight in Sawyer Smith. But again, against a better team, it could have very well cost Florida. And yeah, it's really cool to get the touchdown at the end. I'd rather put the game out of reach and go down and knee the ball and know that you're going to win, rather give Kentucky a chance offensively to tie, to score a touchdown, get a two-point conversion, and to potentially tie the game. That did not happen. But again, you've got to be smarter than that. You've got to be smarter than that. And again, if I was in the news conference after the game, that's what I would ask Dan Mullen is, did you instruct your players to go down after getting a first down? Did you tell them that in the huddle, you know, leading up to right before Josh Hammond scored the 76-yard touchdown to put the game away for the Gators? Again, my name is Mark Bergin. This is another edition of Berg is the Word. If you enjoyed this, please feel free to retweet it with your friends. If you have any questions after the fact, I am happy to do my best to answer them about tonight's game. But again, Kyle Trask in relief of Feleipe Franks, the Gators scoring on three of their four drives. Trask coming into the game down 11, leading the Gators to a comeback win 29-21. Ted Jacks Beach, Florida says, what a fantastic game. And yeah, what I would ask is, you know, what you thought of Kyle Trask's play in relief of Feleipe Franks. I really think that was the difference. And the Gators were really struggling to that point. Again, down 11 points on the road in Lexington in what was a hostile environment. And the Gators storming back, scoring 29 consecutive points. Ted Jacks Beach says, love my Gators. Ted, I hope you love my analysis and my breakdown of tonight's game. But a really entertaining one in Lexington. Again, the Gators will have Tennessee next week. So we'll see what happens there. Tennessee beat UTC, the University of Tennessee Chattanooga, today. So I know Tennessee has really, really struggled. I'd imagine the Gators will be heavy favorites in that game next weekend. Meanwhile, Kentucky's got Mississippi State on the road next weekend. Ted Jaxby, my thoughts pretty much are this, is that, you know, Frank's injury, you wish him the best with an injury, but I thought Trask played outstanding again. The Gators scoring on three out of the four drives that he came in relief of Franks, and it really seemed to spark the team. And again, my big thing at the very end with Josh Hammond scoring the 76-yard touchdown, go down after getting the first down rather than allowing Kentucky the chance and the opportunity to tie the game. Again, the Gators went up 8, but instead of giving Kentucky another chance from an offensive standpoint, go down, get the first down, you can knee the ball, and you can win 22-21 versus giving Kentucky the chance with 33 seconds left to potentially drive down the field, score a touchdown, also convert a two-point conversion. That did not happen, but again, that goes back to coaching and situational awareness by the players. And what I would want to know if I was a media member is, did Dan Mullen instruct that to his players to go down after getting a first down? Or, you know, was that even talked about in the huddle at all in terms of, you know, Florida just needed to get a first down. Kentucky didn't have the timeouts to stop the clock. So that would be a question that I'd have for Dan Mullen in the news conference. And we'll find out what he says here shortly after. But that was really my thoughts. And I thought Trask played outstanding. He's a junior, and it looks like he's going to be, you know, the leader of the Gators moving forward. But again, coming down from 11 on the road for, you know, someone who you know, has some game experience, but doesn't have a lot. I thought it was really, really impressive, and it really rallied the Gators. And again, it looks like Florida's going to be without Feleipe Franks moving forward. So that's really my big takeaway from tonight's game. Again, my name is Mark Bergin. This is another edition of Bergin's Word. We go ahead and sign off here. Hope all of you have a great rest of your nights. Enjoy college football. Enjoy week two of the NFL tomorrow, too. I'll be on Twitter. You can always find me at MD Bergin. I'm going to go ahead and sign off here. Hope all of you have a great rest of your nights. Take care and so long, everyone.